it's Allison from Computers.mom, and this video will show you how to create a Gmail context group from an existing email or another kind of list. When you email with the same group of people regularly, it's really helpful to be able to email them as a group without having to add them one at a time. That grouping of contacts is often called a distribution list. If you already have the names and email addresses available in a previous email or as a list on your computer, you can create a distribution list quickly and easily. In this video, I'm going to show you three ways to do that, depending on what your list looks like. Don't worry about taking notes because you'll find a recap of the steps at the end of this video. You will need to know how to copy and paste. If you're not familiar with copy and paste, we have tutorials for those linked in the description of this video. To get started, be sure you are signed into Gmail in a browser on your computer like this. We're not going to use a mail app. You need to be in a browser like Chrome, Safari, Microsoft Edge, or Firefox. Let's start with the simplest case. You have already exchanged email with a bunch of people and you want to make them into a group. Open any previous email to that group. It can be in your sent mail or your inbox, as long as it has the right people on it. Click the down arrow next to the names. In the window that appears, you see all the relevant email addresses. In this case, all my people are in the To section, not CC or BCC. While we're here, take a look at how this list is formatted. Each contact has a name and an email address, and the contacts are separated by commas. There's only one contact here who has a proper name, Freddie Rosten. The rest just have the email address in quotes in place of the proper name. Each email address is surrounded by angle brackets. We're going to copy all of these and paste them into our contacts. Click and drag to select them and then copy them using Command-C on a Mac or Control-C on Windows. Now we need to open Google Contacts. Since you're signed into your Gmail account, you'll see a grid of dots on the upper right. Click on the grid of dots and you'll see a list of the apps connected to your Gmail account, including Contacts. Select Contacts and a new tab opens up showing your Google Contacts. Your contacts are listed in the main part of the window, and down the left are all the tools for managing them. Currently, there are 11 contacts in this account. Note this section, Labels. That's what Google calls distribution lists. Right now, I have two, Book Group, which has three members, and Test, which has two. Suppose we want to add all the people we just copied to a new label called Coffee Group. On the upper left, click the blue button that says Create Contact, and then select Create Multiple Contacts. We don't want to do these one at a time. In the Create Multiple Contacts window, note that it says No Label. Click there, and then click Create Label. Type a name for your label, and click Save. You see the label appear on the left. Now paste the names and email addresses you copied before here, where it says Add Names, and click Create. You'll see a working message briefly, and then four contacts have been added. If I click on the label, I can see all the people who are part of that distribution list. If the people were not already in your contacts list, they've been added. My total contacts are now up to 15. Don't worry about duplicates, we'll address that in a moment. Notice that only one of them has a name. The rest only have an email address. You can edit these contacts to add their names if you feel like it, but you don't have to. Also, remember that we copied these people from the To area of the original email. If you had more people in the CCC or BCC sections, you'll need to repeat the process for them, although you won't have to create the label next time because it already exists. To use our new label, return to the tab with our Gmail in it and click Compose. In the To field of the email, begin typing the name of the label, and it immediately shows up and tells us how many members there are. Click to select it, and all the members of that label show up immediately. Easy peasy. And of course, you can use it in the CC or BCC fields as well. By the way, you may have noticed that there is also a Labels section in your Gmail, not to be confused with the labels in your contacts. Labels are just a convenient way of organizing information in each of these apps. At this point, you could be done, unless you don't have the contact list in a prior email. Perhaps you have it in a different format. Maybe you have a typed list of names like this, or a spreadsheet like this. Let's take those cases next. Here's a list of email addresses in the Notes app on my computer. Note that any type list will do, with one contact per line, so I don't have to put commas between them. The process is almost the same as before. Once again, we just select them all, copy them, head over to our Google Contacts. Click Create Contact, then Create Multiple Contacts. Let's select the coffee group label again and be sure to click Apply. Then paste the copied names into the window. Now we have a problem. Notice that everything starting with Harriet Tubman isn't working, and we have an error message down here. That's because there's both a name and an email address for her, but we haven't formatted it properly. Let's go back to the list and add angle brackets around the email address like you saw before, and try again. Copy the list, go back to Contacts, Create Multiple Contacts, select the label, paste, create. Now it works. Once it's done working, these six contacts have been added to the coffee group. Sometimes your list is in a spreadsheet like this, and the process is a little different. First, open the spreadsheet and save it as a CSV file. How you do that depends on your setup, but generally you're looking on the file menu for something like Save As or Export, and then choosing CSV as the format. CSV is short for comma separated values, which if you remember our first example, is how the computer thinks about the data. The values are separated by commas. Don't worry about the possible data loss message if you see that, just close the file. Now you can see on our desktop that there are two files, the original spreadsheet and the new CSV file. Open Google Contacts again, but this time select Import. We select and apply the label as we did before, and this time click Select File. Browse to the location where we saved the CSV file, on the desktop in this case, select it, and click Upload. Once you see the file name in the window, click Import. But now we have a new problem. As you might have guessed, I did this on purpose so you will know what to do if it happens to you. Google is not recognizing the headers. That means that we need to label the columns of information in the spreadsheet so that they can be imported into the right slots in the contacts. First names in the first name field, last names in the last name field, and so on. All we have to do to fix it is open up the CSV file and add headings to the columns. Let's add a row above the names and make this a little bigger so you can see it. Google is very picky about the way you name the headings, and if your data is more complicated than this, you may need to use their template to make sure the import works properly. But with this simple three-column list, using first name, last name, and email as our headers will work. Don't forget to save your changes. Now let's go back to the contacts and try this again. Import, let's label these test, select the file, upload, import, and boom! All the contacts are added, they're properly formatted with the names and email addresses, and they're labeled. Note that you may be prompted to check for duplicates automatically, or you can always use the merge and fix option to look for duplicates whenever you're ready. One other thing to note, when you import a list of contacts instead of pasting them, Google automatically adds a label called imported on whatever the date is, so you don't lose track of which contacts were imported in which group. Back in our Gmail tab, we can write to test, and all of those contacts show up immediately. It's so easy now. So that's the whole story. Here's a quick recap of the steps we just went through. Cases 1 and 2, contacts in an email or a list. If your contacts are in a previous email, use the drop-down arrow in the email to expand the list. You will need to repeat this if your contacts are in 2 and CC and BCC. Once you can see the list of contacts, select and copy them. Open your Gmail contacts by clicking the grid of dots on the upper right corner of the Gmail screen and selecting Contacts. Click Create Contacts, Create Multiple Contacts. Choose or add a label, and then paste the data into the window and click Create. If your contacts are in a spreadsheet, make sure to add headers to the spreadsheet and save it as a CSV file. In Google Contacts, click Import, choose or add a label, and then browse to the file, click Upload, and then click Import. That's all there is to it. Thanks for watching. Please click like if you found this helpful. Feel free to leave comments and questions below, and don't forget to subscribe for more Computers.Mom videos.